Of course. I'm obsessed with people who do very bad things for all the good reasons. So I started telling the story of a man who is forced to go into a life of crime because he needs the money, like we all need money. But I started writing it in 2019. And then in 2020, the pandemic came along and I lost my job. I didn't come to friends. I was supposed to come in 2020. I lost my insurance. And so I was very scared and angry. And so that part of the story grew into an exploration of what people do because the American healthcare system is horrific. So I got a nice taste of the other side. And it wasn't just me, everybody was struggling, no one had insurance, everyone was losing their jobs. So I wanted to explore that, and then it became a novel about crime and supernatural elements that explored really the actions of desperate people and how far are they willing to go. So a lot of people ask me, what is the book about? I'm saying it's three guys who are trying to do the right thing in the most horrific ways possible. So one of them has a baby coming, the other one lost his entire family, and the last one is trying to get his mom into a better place. So they're good guys, just they don't know how to go about being good guys, so they do really, really bad stuff. Of course, in 2015, I finished, it's called Santa Muerte in France. And I knew that it was a crime novel because it had a lot of crime elements, but I've always been in love with horror, so it had some horror elements. But crime horror was not a thing. And then the few people that read it before it was published told me, you're Latino, this is magical realism. So I was like, okay, so it's crime, it's horror, it's magical realism. I don't have a name for it. But I've always been obsessed with noir, with the aesthetic, the grittiness, the realness of noir. And it was also the first book where I completely engaged in bilingual writing. So it was in English and in Spanish and in Spanglish. So I knew that I had to call it something else. And when you open a book in the United States, you have the title, and then right underneath it says a novel. And that was very boring, and I didn't want to use that. So I started thinking, it's about my people, it's about the individuals that I've met since I moved to the United States. It's about my people in the neighborhood, just normal people. Poor neighborhoods are called barrios. And I said, wait a minute, it's the people in the barrio, and it's noir, and if I put it together, I don't have to explain that it's magical realism, and it's horror, and it's crime, and it's noir, and it's a thriller, and it's a mystery. So I'll just call it Barrio Noir, and used it for the first time in 2015, and then it stuck, so I put it on the following novel, The Coyote Songs, and then When the Devil Takes You Home came out with my first big publisher. They respected that, so they went with Barrio Noir, and now I'm in France talking about it, so it stuck, yeah. I think I'm obsessed with the way that we present people in fiction. I think we should stick to the most realistic depictions possible. And I, for one, when I'm scared, I turn to humor. It's the coping mechanism. So when things get very, very, very dark, I just tell jokes. So my novels get very, very dark. So I think when you're pummeling your reader with darkness and grief and violence, you also have to give them an opportunity to breathe, to remember that when your life gets dark, you can go outside and get some coffee or listen to the birds or, you know, to try to work that balance in there. If it's all about, you know, ghosts and pain and demons and guns, and then it becomes, it's like it's a single note. So I want to have, you know, different melodies so that it's really dark and really violent, and then you have some light moments, and humor is amazing that way. So it lets you do magical things so that people don't get bored of the constant oppressive darkness.